Then all the elders of Israel gathered together and came to Samuel at Ramah and said to him, "Behold, you are old, and your sons do not walk in your way. Now appoint for us a king to judge us like all the nations." So then came Saul, first king of Israel, but his faith was weak and ended up killing himself. So David, son of Jesse, took his place, who was a man after God's own heart. Though he had his flaws, he still played the part of a king who pointed to the King of all kings. His son Solomon reigned after him. No one was wiser in all the land, but he served with a divided heart. So he left a divided kingdom: northern kingdom Israel and southern kingdom Judah. Northern kingdom Israel had 19 kings in all. None were faithful to the Lord, which would lead to their downfall. There's Jeroboam, Nadab, Baasha, and Elah, Zimri, and Omri, Ahab, Ahaziah, and Joram, Jehu, Jehoahaz, Jehoash, Jeroboam the second, Zechariah, Shallum, they fell to the Assyrians. Yes, God can punish a bad nation with a worse one, a worse one. And God did punish a bad nation with a worse one. Northern kingdom Israel, 19 kings all bad. Let's not forget about southern kingdom Judah, where 8 out of 20 kings Asa and Jehoshaphat, Jehoram, Ahaziah, Athaliah, and Joash, Amaziah, Uzziah, Jotham, and Ahaz, Hezekiah, Manasseh, Amon, and Josiah, Jehoahaz, Jehoiakim, Jehoiakim, Zedekiah. Southern kingdom Judah, where 8 out of 20 kings were faithful to all the good, there was still a lot of bad. So God allowed Nebuchadnezzar to carry them off to Babylon in 586 BC. But God wasn't done with them. You'll see, yeah, you will see. Because there was still one king who had yet to come, Jesus Christ, born of a virgin, and he came to earth to set the captives free. He lived a perfect life and was crucified and rose on the third day so that we might have life in him for all eternity. Jesus, King of all.